Oh, this is a funny one, yeah. So somebody there on the telephone today got through and was like, we hear that you have been listed as, that you have something against you, a lien, or no, not a lien, it was something else, a court action. Yeah, so they had that on the thing, and it said that you're gonna need a lawyer and all of this, and then it said, it was like a recording, and then it was a big intimidator, you know, it was first thing in the morning, I'm like, oh, great, intimidate me. So then they were saying all of these things that they were gonna be after me, they're gonna halt my bank accounts and all of these things. So it kept going on and on, and I'm like, well, so I searched out the number, and then I find out that this particular number had, a lot of people had this particular lawyer firm had called them. So this lawyer firm goes and leaves this automatic message. So they must have a list of people. And leaves this automatic message, and they said, oh, it said that we have your social security number and all this stuff. A real intimidator. And I'm like, how could they be lawyers? I thought that being a lawyer, they had to say, stay with the bar, and they had to give a Hippocratic oath that they didn't, you know, intimidate people. That's ridiculous. And so I'm like, well, who is suing them? Who is suing that lawyer firm? There's there in San Jose, and it starts with a C and a C. That's what I'll give out. I won't give their name, but yeah. So they are definitely reckless intimidators. And I didn't think that was legal. I didn't think a law firm was allowed to do that. Anyway, so, in all the lookups, everybody's saying they're spam. Just like they let it go or spam, but still is the point, you know. Why? It's kind of funny in my case, because I don't really have any money, but they're going to freeze my bank account. It's like, well, that would be really hysterical, you know. It's kind of an extra humiliant. Freeze the zero, lady. Okay. Anyway. Whoa, what a weird freak job from California all of you are. I can't believe California, actually, that they are so malicious. Malicious health system and the malicious lawyer system. I just can't believe it. Really, really backwards. They become very backwards, and instead of helping human beings, they just become a swarm of hurt. Anybody in those governmental offices, or these health offices, or these lawyer offices, they're just swarms of hurt. So, yeah. And I was, you know, it's my state, and I, well, forget it. It's a state ruined. State ruined. Anyway, I was trying to talk about being a vegan, not a vegetarian, being a vegan. I've been a vegan for a long, long time. But then recently I started looking up all these vegan recipes, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I missed out on being a vegan. Maybe there are super recipes that I'm supposed to be entertaining with, you know, in my mind. You know, I'm supposed to have the nut cream cheese, and I'm supposed to have this other style of spiralizer. I need a Vitamix, you know. And I'm like, I look up the Vitamix, it's like $500 or something. I'm like, well, no, I guess I'm not going to ever get a Vitamix. That's ridiculous. But my gosh, I had no idea a blender could cost that much. Oh my goodness. So there they are. They're blending in this instant thing, which is great. But I'm missing out on all those sauces. You make all the sauces, you add the fruit and the avocado with the fruit. Like, you add mango and avocado together, and then you add in like soy or like a soy sauce or amino, one of those Bragg's amino, that type of thing. And that makes a really interesting sauce. But yeah, for salads. So all of these different things that you can go at and try. And I'm like, well, all right. So, but it's weird because I've been a vegan, and then I'm like, all of a sudden trying the vegan recipes, you know, that have been listed. And that's almost like a new, it's like a new window is open, a new door is open, and I'm like, what? I've been missing out, apparently. I've been missing out because there's a whole bunch of ways to prepare the food differently, you know. And I don't know. I didn't know I could make cheese. That's the main thing. I didn't know I could make cheese. You can make the hard cheese with the agar. If you can get the agar powder, they have it at many of the Asian the Asian markets. It's an agar powder, and then that is very good to make the harder cheese. They also have the tapioca starch, which comes from a cassava root down deep in Brazil area. Now this cassava root, it makes, you just take one or two teaspoons and it will make your cheese. You add that to like some of that, you know, almond milk, and it makes like a goo. It makes it really gooey and stretchy, like a melted nacho cheese style. And I'm like, well, I've been a vegan all this time, I never even had the melted nacho style. So what's going on with it that now I'm supposed to desire it again? It's almost like going backwards, you know, back to American cheese melts, to look at the thing that just keeps melting and melting. In the spoon, it's amazing. You just put two of those tapiocas in, and it'll just take whatever, and it just pulls at it and pulls at it. And it's like, what's the deal? So now you can make nachos and all of that. With that type of cheese, you can add all kinds of... what was the next thing? I don't know. You could throw in your ground nuts. You know, they're ground really fine, soaked and ground, and then you throw them in. And then if you don't want the nuts, you can use a potato, a cooked potato and carrot, or you can use a sweet potato. So all of these things make cheese. And then you can use that nutritional yeast also. I have a bit of that nutritional yeast, and that's kind of interesting. It has that weird flavor. I've tried lecithin also, and that works. But another recipes vegan that are amazing that I have never tried before, but lately, is the ice cream. You can make the vegan ice cream with... I am gonna actually just choke the coconut milk can. It has so many calories. One can is almost 780 calories sometimes. So be very careful, because some of these vegan ice cream recipes say two cans of that. And I'm like, no way. They're not gonna get me fat. So I'm thinking, okay, I'll compromise. I'll take a little bit of that, and then go off to like the almond milks or the cashew milks, because they are really low in calories. So combine those with like your carob or your cocoa powder, and then some kind of maple syrup. And there, or dates. And then there was another woman, she was just saying, you put like 2 cups of dates. And I'm like, how much money do you have that you put 2 cups of dates into your ice cream? I mean, that's like $20 almost. So I'm like, no, that's stupidity. You can't be doing that. That's not the way to go. You tell people to be vegan, and then it costs, you know, thousands of dollars. That's very wrong. So just use the maple syrup, and just use the other thing. Well, not honey. You know, I was supposed to use the honey, but if you're a vegan honey, if you're a honey vegan, then use the honey. But yeah, you've got the agave and all that to use instead. Oh my gosh, or brown rice syrup. Yeah, so be careful with that ice cream. But I'm making ice cream now, and it's very easy. You put it in a regular blender, and there it is. I didn't know I had that skill. So it's a very odd thing to be now. I'm incorporating these old Americana recipes of ice cream and melted cheese, and it's just kind of strange. It's kind of strange. I feel like it's an odd, I don't know, it's like a Rockwell decadence time, and I don't really know if that's necessary. So anyway, so I'm thinking that the future, and I'm looking at the next 5 years as being very, very eye-opening for a lot of populace, for their health, for vegan majority, for us to up to into the majority more and more. You've got to get to be vegan majority, because when that happens, we free these animals out of these farms. They're shutting down already 42, I believe it is 42 dairy farms in New York City area, because people are eating the nut milks, they're drinking the nut milks, they're drinking the hemp milk, they're drinking the soy milk and the rice milk. They're lower in calories. It's just the way it goes, you know. And hopefully, you know, there's just going to be a big trend across the United States, across the world, and just keep going. Shut them down. Shut down those dairy farms. You know, and then it'll be next to butter. Well, they have beautiful choices in butter available, and you don't have to eat a whole bunch, and they're very tasty. I'm not a big butter either, but some people are. They have the Earth Balance. It's a very good one, and I'm sure there are other ones available. But yeah, you can even make your own. That's a very, very, that's a basic change that anybody can do. Anybody can get rid of the regular old butter and use the newer kind. And what else do we need the cows for? I'm not talking about the paleo diet people. What else did we need the cows for? It was the ice cream. I just told you how to make it. Then we had we had lots of soy yogurts out there already. I'm not a big yogurt fan, because I get kind of sick of all of those dancers. They only eat one yogurt a day, and then while they're at the rehearsal, they eat their one yogurt, and it's kind of sickening. So I don't even go for the yogurts anymore. They ruined it for me. They ruined it. What else is the dairy for? That's about it. It's the butter and the milk. So that will be no longer a necessity. And with the chickens, we don't need their eggs any longer. We have the flax. Make those flax eggs, and they get all gooey. You stir in the water with it, the ground flax, and it becomes like just the constant goo. So you don't need the eggs. Okay, so what, and yeah, you don't need the cholesterol either. And so all of these are good things, you know. It starts to come out more and more good things, you know. Your cholesterol gets lower. You go from a 75% chance of heart disease to 4% being a vegan versus a meat eater. So it's a huge, vast jump on your heart. Your heart is like, whoa, 4%. 4% chance of having a heart attack versus 75 for heart disease, I'll say. Okay, so then Vegetarians, I believe, are hovering around 25, 30. They're still up there because they're eating that cheese. Yeah, vegetarians, you're still in the heart attack world. You haven't jumped on the vegan boat. Okay. So what else was in there? Well, we have the eggs. There was something else I read lately, but was another way of eating eggs. Another type of form of eggs. I can't come up with it right now, but it was a good one. A very good one. So I think I told you how to make the soft cheese and the hard cheese. And there's a delicious cream cheese out there. A lot of it, just look at Boursin style. Those are nice, very nice ones. And then off you go. You can make your own mozzarella cheese. It has kind of fun things going on with it. But it's weird because I've just been a vegan without the cheese want. So it's an interesting, strange to start adding it in. You know what I mean? Interesting. Yeah. Because before, if you don't look at the cheese, it really is just the nuts. You eat a lot of nuts. And then you eat a lot of the vegetables and a lot of fruit. That's it. And then olive oil. Our regular olive oils type of thing. But that's all. But now I'm adding this cheese in. It's like I'm adding new food into my body. And it's very odd because a lot of it is that starch makers. You know, they're the agar is a starch maker. And it's a seaweed. It's a type of seaweed. And this cassava is a starch maker from the tapioca starch. It's odd to bring that in. When before that wasn't, you know what I mean? It's very strange. So yeah, I've been an anti-cheese. An anti-vegan cheese even, okay. I guess I was talking earlier about we need more of these vegan politicians. There was one guy I saw called Earthly Ed, and he's in United Kingdom. And he was there with the microphone doing his Martin Luther King vegan style that we're going to take this world by storm. And he's a good motivator. He's not an emotional fighter like me. You know, when you're in the trenches, I freak. When he was in the trenches, he didn't, you know. when you're on these agri farms, some people just can't handle it. And some people can. Some people just, I don't know why, I guess, they're afraid of farmers? Maybe they're afraid of farmers. I just think the farmers are terrible followers, and I have no respect for the majority of them. So, anyway, I'm looking at 5 years. A vegan takeover. So can we keep that on our plate as a goal? As a goal as to how many we can become. And yeah, true, we probably less and less. The vegans are not big populators, you'll find. So we'll have these carnivores having their heart attacks with populating, you know. I don't know what we're gonna do except it be teachers, you know. And when you have great news like that with the heart disease issue, 75% to 4%, you know, that has to be advertised. You know, we have to bring that out, because I'm looking at carnivores as non-sympathetic to animals. I'm looking at them as extremely non-sympathetic, that they themselves are the killers, that they themselves are the bloodletters, are the ones who strip the animals, the young from the old, from their mothers. I see them as the doers, you know. So each time that you see that woman, you know, grab that chicken off the shelf, and you see her grab that what is it, like a chicken fried steak that they make it pre-make, the type of thing. You see them grab the ham right off the shelf, you know, it's all not pre-wrapped, you know. They're just murderers. Each and every one of those people that are grabbing that item is a murderer. Now, because I have to take care of an elder here, sometimes he has made a request, you know, that he has to have ham. And this becomes difficult, you know, because I'm like, no, he doesn't. We have news out that bring vegan in and it lessens, it lowers the chances of dementia, it lowers the chances of Alzheimer, it stops it in its tracks, it makes our brains wiser and wittier. Okay, so because we have these wittier brains, my goodness, that's another plus for vegans. So we're looking to have wittier brains. So the diet for that, the superfoods, I'm not saying you only eat these, but they're superfoods for to halt dementia and Alzheimer. Oh my gosh, my aunts, all my aunts have these terrible neck things where their necks just fall. Very bad posture issues. They can't hold up anymore. It's the apathy. It's the body apathy. Now all of this I can only attribute to this, what I'm about to tell you. Okay. On the list was only four things. And these four things I don't believe they were big eaters of, nor were they big doers of. Number one on the list was berries. Was blueberries, blackberries, and strawberries. Number two on the list was kale and spinaches. Eat your kales and spinaches. Three on the list was seaweed. You have to incorporate seaweed soups, seaweeds into your routine. You know, eat those seaweeds. And number four was exercise. Exercise. There, and I know, the older we get, it's tougher to exercise, but sometimes the women in the past never exercised. The older women never exercised. They didn't. It was just, maybe, you know, they would watch the Rockettes do it on stage, but they never exercised. It was just not done. They brought that bike with the exercise bike in at Sears or something. And that was about it, and not everybody bought it. So, and very rarely did they go on walks. So the women that we're seeing that are in their 70s and their 80s and their 90s, a lot of them never exercised. So it's a very strange group, isn't it? That did not. It's very odd. But yeah, that is part of that's part of the incorporation, you know, that part of dementia and Alzheimer. It just feeds off of not exercising. So very important that we bring it back. Bring it back in all through our life, even when we're old people. Old, you know, we're going to have to do that. So anyway, like my dad, he's doing very well. He's doing well as a vegan. Now, he doesn't vegan all the time. He does have his, unfortunately, he goes to a restaurant and he gets wooed in by the menu. So he can only be a vegan under my severe tutelage as the chef. But with the others, when he goes to restaurants, I don't know. That's the damage. That's the damage that ends up happening. But all in all, he's doing very well, brain-wise. His brain is still working, you know what I mean? And I'm thinking about when you go back to the old time, before this past 100 years, there used to be a lot of old witty people, you know, a lot more wittier and wiser before industrialization, before all of this incorporation of pesticides in our food supply. We were just smarter people. I just believe so. I mean, read an Emily Bronte or something, and you'll be like, what the heck? I mean, how could anybody be that smart? How? Is that possible? I just think our processed food supply has just destroyed our brains and destroyed our bodies. And then we are all running around saying Alzheimer. Well, that's the truth. We're all running around saying Alzheimer now. And just try to avoid it. So let's eat healthy and be vegan and not keep that exercise. And I'm not a good seaweed cook, but I'm gonna have to be. I have to add that seaweed in, even though it's Fukushima seaweed. I still have to eat it. And then what's the next thing would be the berries for the brain. And the kale and the spinaches, also for the brain. So yeah. Anyway, yeah. Veganaholic, veganetician, be a vegan politician. We need teachers out there, and we need doers, a lot of doers, because supporting the old way is just destroying the planet. Along with yourself, yeah. And I believe your compassion self, your emotion state, returns to you the less meat you eat. You take it off your palate, you take it off your plate, you will be a more compassionate human being, a more giving human being. You will be less stingy. You will be a more honorable human being. All right, that's all for tonight.